Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how you can use the InfraNodus Knowledge Graph browser extension that visualizes any text you have as a knowledge graph of topics and the relations between them in order to develop your ideas and to generate interesting insights. Here I have a text that I wrote about my new book, and this is a summary of what the book is about. The book is called Waves into Patterns, and I visualized it using the InfraNodus extension Knowledge Graph. And so how I like to use it is to basically have an overview of what it is that I've been thinking about to show me what are the different topics that I covered that you can see here. The book is talking about wave patterns and natural systems, and then there are many different other topics such as perception variability and dynamic growth. So it gives you this nice visual overview. It shows you how the different topics are connected, which is already good if you want to sort of get into a starting point to think about your text and to develop it further, right? You have like a really good overview of the main topics and relations between them, but then you can also use this to explore each topic in detail. So for example, zooming in and seeing what are the concepts inside every topic, see if you missed anything that maybe you find important, or on the other hand, see if you can also connect those topics and ideas in new and interesting ways. So in fact, in the InfraNodus extension, you have these different views, like the topical view, which is a high level overview of the main ideas. Then you have the concepts view that shows you the main concepts inside the text. This is a more granular zoomed in view that changes the way that you perceive text and you start exploring it in much more detail, thinking about the specific nuanced relationships between the different concepts you use. And then you also have the gap view that shows you the gaps between the different topics, so which topics are not yet well connected in the text. And usually for me this is the most inspiring part, because I see, for instance, that I wrote something about dynamic growth and complex simplicity, but I didn't write about those two topics in the same context. So there could be an idea that can link those topics in an interesting way, and this will give me this feedback, and then I can either think of a connection myself, maybe look at the concepts that are contained in each of those topics to understand a little bit better, you know, how they could be connected, or I can also use the built-in AI to generate a prompt, an interesting research question that I can then try to answer myself if I like to think about this topic on my own, or send it to chat and develop it further using AI. So it's really like a combination of using AI and your own thinking, and to help AI not to generate content for you, but to rather guide your thinking in the directions where you are most likely to discover the new ideas. Because this knowledge graph will always show you what's there, how it's connected, but also what's missing. Because when you look at this visualization, you will start to naturally try to make the connections that you haven't made before, and also notice that there are gaps between some topics that you didn't think of, and then you will naturally try to make connections between them. And as well, when you look at the main topical structure, you might think, okay, there's actually one topic that I didn't talk about at all. For instance, in this case, it would be something about politics, right? So that could be interesting for me as well, to kind of like see how I can go beyond the periphery of this graph and explore the topics that I haven't yet mentioned in this text. So let me take you step by step through how it actually works, so you can apply it to your own workflows. First of all, you need to have a text to start with. It can be your own text, like I have in this case, or it could be an existing blog article. For instance, if you like to use something that's already there, I like to use Aeon, which is like a really great online magazine of really interesting articles. And I usually open an article, and then I open the InfraNodus extension there. I'm gonna show you how I do that in a moment, but first I will use it on my own article, which is about my book, Waves into Patterns, which is a book on the different types of variability that is taking the reader on a journey through different modes of variability that you find in living systems and in nature, and shows you how each type of variability can be useful and interesting for specific purposes. So it's talking about repetitive patterns, also fractal patterns, and then it also proposes different perspectives, how you can see this variability from the point of view of time, how the process evolves in time, or also how it evolves as a combination of different centers and islands of activity that grow and then decline and reorganize and reconnect. Also from the perspective of networks, it even has a part that talks about prey-predator dynamics, so variability of competitive interactions, and then even music and rhythm and so on, right? So the book has a really diverse set of subjects, but also, I wrote it because I'm thinking about this topic and I want to develop it further. So this is a very good summary of the book that I wrote for my own website. And I can use it as a starting point to then think how I can develop these ideas further. And the way that I would approach it is to actually write the text, then obviously read it myself, see if I'm missing anything. But then I will launch the Infranodus extension right on that text. I can also do it in WordPress when I'm writing this actual text, right? And then Infranodus visualizes this graph. By default, it shows me the main topics. So that gives me a good visual overview of the main topics inside. So I see that this introduction that I wrote is about wave patterns. That makes sense because this is one of the main topics in the book. It's called Waves into Patterns. Perceptual variability, so that's also very important. I'm glad that it picked up on this topic because it's very important. This book is talking a lot about how you can change your perception and increase variability of your perception so that you can become more sensitive to all kinds of scales and frequencies of perception, how you can see the smallest things and the biggest things, and then also fractal signs, how you can see the smallest nuances but also have an ability to look at the bigger picture, dynamic growth, aesthetic experience, that's important, rhythmic adaptation. If I see that, for instance, aesthetic experience is something I'm interested in, I can click on this topic, see the concepts that are contained inside. So here I'm talking about aesthetic, practical experience, implication, and so on, right? So then it gives me an understanding of, okay, I'm talking about the aesthetic experience that you get from the sense of variability. And as I know the text already, it helps me remember on a more granular level what this topic is about, but I can also go into context and see the different statements that relate to it and refresh all these ideas in my head and then help me think deeper into this topic. And I can also use the built-in summary to create a summary of this topic, just to get like an AI-generated overview of the main ideas, but that relate to aesthetic experience in the context of this text. And I can also ask the built-in AI to generate an interesting question or an idea. And this is how I like to develop the topics further. I select a topic, like I did in this case, aesthetic experience, and then I generate a question, and then it's telling me how can the aesthetic design of Dimitris Paranishkin website, actually that's interesting, enhance user experience while reflecting ecological principles of resilience and adaptability in digital environments. So that's great because it's proposing me, what if you applied your own fascination with fractals into the way that you design your website and how you could do that? And that's a very inspiring thought, actually, because it's almost challenging me to create the form that would reflect the content. And that can be very interesting. And in fact, I'm going to save this idea. So what I can do here is that I click save, and then it opens an Infranodus graph that relates to the extension and this particular website. And then I can save this idea into the graph. And then I have it in my main Infranodus account, which is quite useful because then I can use it to then remind myself that I've been thinking about this and to develop this idea further. Another way how I like to use this visualization of the main topics is to see if I'm missing anything. And here it's a pretty good visualization that allows me to see that, okay, I covered all this topic, but for example, what am I missing here? I think the topic of totalitarianism and how this sort of variability can be used in the context of politics and social organization, how you can create structures that are diverse, that have multiple centers. This is something I haven't yet mentioned in this text enough, right? So that could be an interesting development that I just get from looking at the graph and realizing that the topic was not detected by the system, because maybe I mentioned it a couple of times, but not enough. So that would be another interesting insight from the graph, that you actually see what's not there. And this is how you can use the visualization to generate new idea. What is not yet in the graph, what I could bring in. So that could be another insight that I could have. I can even go back into this graph and write about the political implications and ethical implications of diversifying one's perception. So that could be another idea that I could save here, and then I can go back to it. And then one last thing is that I can look at the concepts. So I'm operating now on a much more granular level of specific concepts. I switch to them and then I'm telling myself, okay, so I'm talking about variability, books. I can even select some of the topics I'm interested in. Let's see if there's anything that pops up that feels like I could develop it further. Maybe I could go into diversity. So let me zoom in here. Diversity. And let's see what it's connected to. When I select the node, it shows me what it's connected to already. Perspective, that could be interesting too. Diversity perspective, and maybe also variability. So now I selected a subcluster of nodes that connect to each other, and then it's the same operation. I can either think of a connection myself, I can show in which context those terms are used, right? So then it helps me understand which part of the text is already talking about them. I can use summary, not needed in this case because it's just one statement, or I can generate a question with AI, which I can then use to inspire myself to think in this direction, or even use it as a prompt. So when I generate this text, I can actually send it to chat and then generate a response to this chat using the AI. So you really have different stages of how you can kind of interact with this and how deep you go into this exploration. If you want, you think on your own, but if you want, you can have the AI nudge your thinking process a little bit by providing some interesting inspirations. So let me choose diversity again. I can also use the search box here, and then variability and ecological. So that's my selection here. And then I can then work with this part of the graph only and have the AI generate content that relates to it, or just think myself in this direction. So that would be how you operate on this more granular level of concepts. The first level is the overview. You see what's there, what's missing, dive into the topics to explore them in more detail, then deselect it, just show the topics only, then go to concepts and only look at the concepts, and then explore them on a more granular level in a kind of zoomed in fashion. The first one is zooming out, the second one is zooming in, and then the third one is a very interesting one. It's one of my favorite modes, is when it detects the gaps between the topics. So here it selects the topics that are not well connected and proposes me to think of a connection between them. For instance, in this text, I'm talking about the aesthetic experience and dynamic growth. But what about the aesthetic experience of dynamic growth? Maybe there's an interesting insight there. So I can also ask Infernos to show me slightly more nodes so I can see what those clusters are about. I see that it's about those cycles of saturation and growth and maybe experience and aesthetic experience. And then I can ask the AI to generate a question that would bridge these gaps together. And here it's telling me, how might the aesthetic experience derived from interactive web frameworks influence our understanding of social network dynamics and ecological saturation and population growth? So that's actually great, because it's again proposing me to think of this connection between how we can create experiences using user interface and websites, but in a way that would enhance the understanding of social networks dynamics. So perhaps this book could have a companion that would be some online interactive tool that would enable you to explore the concepts from this book in this interactive way that you could engage with it using your own content, for example, or your own data, the sound, the visuals, and so on. So this is again like an interesting idea that I can save, because it proposes me how I can develop these concepts further. So this is the gap view, right? It detects the gaps and then it shows you what are the existing gaps and how you can connect them together. And usually I like to reiterate through a few gaps to see if there's, for instance, this one is an interesting one, waves into patterns and rhythmical adaptation. So I'm talking about rhythm, I'm also talking about waves into patterns, but I'm not talking about them in the same context enough in this text. So here it's proposing me to think of how can the patterns of ecological variability described in waves into patterns inform our understanding of rhythmical adaptability in complex systems, particularly regarding how entities grow and decline over time. So that's nice, because it's proposing me to think of how things in societies and populations and systems grow and decline, and what would be the rhythm for this growth and decline, and if there is any cyclical processes there, if it also has fractal properties and so on. So that can be another inspiring thought to have in relation to this book, which I'm going to save into my main graph. And as you see, as I'm saving all those ideas, I'm building a new graph itself inside Infernodus, which I can use in the same way for ideation or to have a good overview of the main ideas that I extracted from this original text and kind of build on it later. So that's also like a system that you can use on itself in a sense. And just like I said in the beginning of the video, you can also use it not only on your own text, but also on already existing ones. So here I say, I find an article on Aeon magazine about food and people. I don't know what it's about. I actually sometimes like to read articles in this way. So I will visualize the article using the graph. and then it gives me a visual representation of what the article is about. So I say it's about body politics, natural entanglement, Nietzschean morality, some crocodile encounter. So I can click here and ask the system to summarize it for me, because it's a long article, so you see there's a lot of statements. I can just ask the AI to summarize this particular topic that it detected in this text. So what is this topic about crocodile encounter? And here it's telling me that the text recounts a harrowing experience of Val Plumwood, an Australian eco-philosopher who survived near fatal crocodile attack, and then how he kind of uses this experience to propose a different understanding of our place in the universe and among animals, and how humans are usually too focused on themselves, and maybe there is another way of looking at it where we see ourselves as part of the food chain. And there's even a connection to the philosophy of Nietzsche in this sense. So that's quite an interesting take on this experience, and that gives me an understanding of what the article is about in a nutshell. But as you can see, it's a much more active way of getting a summary, because I'm not just asking the AI to generate a summary. I'm using the graph to get an overview, and then interactively I'm focusing on the topics I find interesting. So it's an active way of reading. It just happens in a non-linear way. Instead of reading from the beginning until the end, I'm just looking at the topics, and then I'm exploring them in detail, just like I did with my own text. And then this helps me generate ideas, because I'm now much more engaged into actually exploring those topics and ideas and the detail in them. So I really like this interface for that. And, you know, you have this like several levels of how deep or how surface you want to go. If you want, you can just look at the topics. If you want, you can go deep and explore the concepts. If you switch here, then you're operating on the level of concepts. It's much more detailed, much more dense, but you can also find some really interesting concepts inside that are maybe hidden at the first glance. And if you feel like you've seen enough here and you want to kind of get to the deeper concepts, you also have this mode where you reveal underlying concepts. So it will select top concepts and remove them from the graph and recalculate the whole metrics. So when you click it a few times, you will usually get to ideas that are a little bit better hidden, right? So not readily available at the surface level. And here you will have something like, let's say, morals, for instance, right? So that was not visible at the first iteration of the graph. And then thought. So I can really get to that like highly granular level of ideas. What does the text say about morals and thoughts? And then I click context, and then I see exactly the part of the text that is talking about moral and thought. So that's quite interesting as well. Here it's saying our moral hatred of suffering only increases it. Translating humanity back into nature might therefore require learning to take joy in certain forms of suffering, especially our own. So you see, it's like how we think about tragedy and how our moral hatred of it actually increases it. So that's quite interesting. Like maybe if we change the way we see it morally, then it also changes our perception of it as well. So there we get to the very specific parts of the text that maybe we wouldn't notice otherwise, but because I know I'm interested in the subject of moral and thought, then I find the part of the text that's relevant to me. And then in the same way, I can also ask the system to visualize the gaps when I click here, gaps, and then I can detect the gaps and then use the built-in AI to generate interesting research questions that would connect these topics which are not yet connected in the text. So it's really like a much more active and engaged way of reading, where I'm generating questions and then I'm trying to answer those questions, and that engages me with the text in a completely different way. Instead of going through it in a linear way, I focus on the parts that I find interesting using the graph as a navigation device. And then with the help of AI, sometimes on my own, I generate interesting questions and go into those ideas further. So this is how it works. I encourage you to try it with your own ideas or with some existing texts that you have. If you don't want to use the extension, you can also use the actual desktop applications where you can import any PDF or any text, or also use multiple sources like Google search results, scientific papers, basically anything you want. You import it here and then you can visualize it the same way as a graph and use it here. If you don't like the 2D version, you can always use the extension on top of InfraNodus itself, so then you have this 3D version on top. Let me know if you have any questions and what your experiences are using this approach, and also if you have any comments, please let me know below under this video. Thank you.